I'm just going to demonstrate quickly how to remove your brake rotors from your hub. Let me just take you around so that you can see. That's a hub, a wheel bearing hub. Okay. It comes off a Nissan one tonner diesel. So I'm going to show you how to do that. We put some brass jaws, okay, into the vise so that you don't damage the disc. Well, the old disc you don't want to worry about too much, but when you're putting in a new disc, okay, so all that we do is we take a power bar, okay, with a size 14 socket, and we'll just go around and loosen them up. There's 6 bolts there, very easily, okay. We loosen up the bolts nicely like that, and then we'll just turn all the bolts out, and that'll loosen the hub from the rotor, okay, or the brake disc, whichever you want to call it. So now it should be loose enough to take out by hand. Okay. So that's it. Okay. Basically 10 mil threads, 14 mil head. Okay. Take them all out. 6 of them. Okay. I'll get back to you when I've got them all out. So with the bolts all out, you can now just gently just pull the hub off. Okay. Just pull it out completely. Okay, and that's what your hub looks like. Okay, and your disc is now loose, and all that you need to do is now remove it from your vise. Okay, and you can go and replace it. Okay, old brake rotor. There's a little horn over there, and it's you know that our engineers say that it cannot be cut anymore, it will go past the safety limit. It is a ventilated disc, so there's not much skimming you can do to that. Then of course we have our wheel bearing hub, which basically just houses the wheel bearings. Okay, this is for the front of the vehicle. Okay, so we have the new disc. Alright, we push the dish side facing us. We put it into the vise. You don't need to clamp it that hard, but I do have aluminium jaws in there so that we don't damage the surface of the machine surface of the disc. Okay, so now what we will do is we'll take our hub. Okay, we obviously you reuse the old hub. We'll put the hub in, line the bolts up, okay, and then just sort of put them in, turn them in by hand first just to give them good thread. Okay, there's 6 of them, so we'll turn them, we put all the bolts in, turn the bolts, but I normally just torque them by hand. I use the power bar and I give them just a good up against and a good nick so that we know it won't come loose. And obviously with the 6 bolts holding this together, you know, it is highly unlikely that this disc will come loose if you tighten it properly. Okay, so I'll go ahead and I'll just go and tighten that, and that is quite simple. I think the secret here is that you got to make sure that you have your correct sized rotor, because they do come in different sizes, heights and thicknesses and so forth. And just make sure that you have your proper disc or rotor for the vehicle which you are working on. Okay, so I'll go ahead and I'll tighten this, and that's how simple it is to put the hub back onto a rotor. Okay. Can you hear that noise? I'm going to have revs.